Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how J progress bars work in Java. So let's get into it. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Hey everybody, we're going to be building a progress bar, and this is defined as a visual aid to let the user know that an operation is processing. So it's usually good practice to let the user know what's going on behind the scenes, if something's processing, you're waiting on something. Otherwise, if there's no sort of visual cue, the user might close out of your application because they think it's frozen. So let's create a progress bar. We're going to create a new class within our project folder. So file, new class. I'll call this progress bar demo, but call it whatever you want. Click finish. Then we're going to create an instance of this within our main class. So we'll type the name of the class, and I'll call this instance just demo equals new progress bar demo. All right, so we're done with this class. Let's go back to our progress bar demo class, and we're going to import a few things. Import java.awt.asterisk and import javax.swing.asterisk. Then let's create the constructor for this class. So we're going to type in the name of the class followed by a set of parentheses and curly braces. And before the constructor, we're going to declare a few things. So we'll create a JFrame, and we'll call this frame equals new JFrame. And we're going to create a component called a JProgressBar. So JProgressBar, and we'll call this bar for short, equals new JProgressBar. Okay, now within the constructor, let's create the frame so we can add the bar to the frame. So frame.setDefaultCloseOperation. JFrame.exitOnClose. And then frame.setSize. Pick whatever size you want. And then I usually set no layout manager, so set layout to null. Only in certain situations I like layout managers. And then we need to take our frame and set the visibility to true. Okay, now we are going to create the J progress bar. So we're going to set the initial value first. So we're going to type bar.setValue. And if you want to start at 0, type in 0 here. Don't know why you'd want to start at a different number, but hey, maybe you can set this to 100 and count down for something. All right, then we're going to set the bounds because we're using no layout manager. So bar.setValue. Bounds, and let's start in the top left corner. So we'll set x to 0, y to 0, and then we'll need to choose a length for this. So maybe I'll type in 420 to match the size of my frame, and then maybe 50 pixels for the height. And then we need to add this bar to our frame. So we'll type in frame.addBar. And let's see what we got so far going on. Okay, we got a nice little bar here, so that's a good start. So with this progress bar, there is actually a special method. So type in bar, and this method is called set string painted, and then pass in true within here. And what this does is that it adds a percentage to your progress bar, and when you fill the progress bar or set the value, this percentage is going to change. So that's kind of cool. All right, so let's fill this progress bar. So all we really need to do is just take this bar and set the value to something else. That's like the bare minimum, I would say. But I think what we'll do is actually put this within a while loop, and we'll have the value of our progress bar increase by a certain amount every second or so. There's so many different ways that you can create a progress bar. This is just like a basic demonstration. So let's do that within a fill method. So at the end of our constructor, we'll call a fill method, and we're going to declare this. So outside of the constructor, we'll make a public void method called fill. And what we'll do is just set the value whenever we call this. All right, so let's just set this to 10 to begin with. So when we run this, it's immediately set to 10. Now what I think we'll do is actually put this within a while loop, and we'll start at zero. So we'll create a counter. So int counter, set this equal to zero, create a while loop, and within the while loop, what we'll do is that we'll continue this while loop as long as our counter is less than or equal to 100. And we're going to take our bar and set the value to whatever our counter is. So if we want to simulate the progress bar increasing over time, we can use the thread.sleep method here. And we can set this to maybe 1000 milliseconds. So this is going to pause our program for 1 second after each iteration of the while loop. And we're going to need to surround this with a try and catch block. And then let's increase our counter, maybe by 10%. So we can say counter plus equals 10. This is the shorthand for saying counter equals counter plus 10. So let's see what happens now. All right, so it starts at zero and it's going up by 10% every second. Almost there. All right. I think I'm going to speed this up a little bit, so maybe I'll change the counter to increment by 1% each time and change the thread.sleep method to perhaps 50 milliseconds. So it's going to appear to go actually faster this time, and it's increasing by 1% after each iteration of the while loop. All right, we can also add some text on our bar. So maybe we'll set this after the while loop is complete. We'll display a message such as done. So we type in the name of the progress bar, set string, and then you can add some text. So maybe we'll type in done. And that should be good. So let's try it again. And then when it's finished, it says done, but it's a little difficult to see. So let's change the font of the progress bar. So if we want to change the font, we can type in bar.setFont. Then within parentheses, we're going to pass in new font, parentheses again. We can pick a font style. I like MV Bully. It's one of my favorite fonts. Then let's set this to bold. So font.bold. And for a size, maybe 25. But bold has to be all capital. I forget about that sometimes. Okay, let's take a look at this now. All right, that's much better. You can actually see it this time. And when it says done, that's actually visible this time and it's not so small. Let's also change the foreground color. So bar.setForeground. Then within here, we just send in a color. So maybe color dot, maybe red. And let's take a look. And the fill color is now red. Actually, this would be kind of cool for some sort of HP bar for a video game, but you'd probably want to start at maybe 100 and then just progress this downwards. And let's also change the background color. So bar.set background, maybe black, color.black. So the background is black and the fill color is red. So another thing, with this J progress bar, within the constructor, you can pass in a minimum and a maximum value for this progress bar. So maybe we'll set the minimum to 0, and then the max, maybe 500. Actually, you know what? Let's create like some sort of HP bar in a video game. So I think what we'll do is actually count downwards. So we'll change our while loop. We'll continue this as long as counter is greater than or equal to 1, or 0, I guess. Actually, greater than 0 would be better. And then we'll decrease our counter by maybe 1. So that's minus equals 1. All right, so let's try this. Oh, we should probably set our counter to whatever this was, 500. Okay, that kind of appears to be somebody's HP draining like in a video game. That's pretty cool too. But we'll switch back to the example we had previously. So I'm just going to undo all of this. But yeah, you can pass in a minimum and a maximum value to your progress bar. All right, everybody, well, that's the basics of J progress bars. And with this set value method of the J progress bar, there's so many different things you can do with this. You won't necessarily have your thread asleep for so many milliseconds before updating this. You might link this to some sort of like task. After the task is complete, you can increment this counter by something. There's really no right way or wrong way to do this. This is just like one of a few different ways to demonstrate this concept. So if you want a copy of all this code, I'll post this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of how J progress bars work in Java. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.